Hey, I'm Evan, head of engineering for RM Stater. Let's upgrade the regulator on your Polaris RZR. Okay, so we're going to start with removing our regulator. This is a 2012 RZR 900 XP four-seater. On the 1000s and the two-seaters and the other models, they all have the regulator mounted in this general location. Sometimes it's kind of on the back of firewall here, sometimes it's underneath. But they're all in the same location. They mount with 10 millimeter hardware, 10 mil bolts and nuts, so they're easy to get off. So I already have everything loosened here. Now, if you're installing our relocation kit, I suggest that you remove the bracket that the regulator is mounted on, since it's a nice piece to reuse to remount your regulator up front. If you're installing a regulator in the stock location, then you just go ahead and remove the two bolts that actually hold the regulator to the bracket. So I already have everything loose. I'm going to go ahead and get the regulator removed. Okay, so now we install our new regulator. You just mount it in the same location. It lines up with the bracket. Reuse the original 10 millimeter hardware and snug everything up to the bracket, and you're ready to go ahead and plug everything in. Okay, so we need to get access to the wiring harness for the regulator so we can unplug it. On this four-seater model, we have two rear seats to remove, and we have an access hatch here. On the two-seaters, there's just an access panel in the back here that has to come out. So I've already removed one seat. I'm going to remove the other one on this side. Okay, and then on this four-seater, the access panel has two little clips here that you have to turn to unlock. There's one on each side. I've already done those. So I'm gonna lift it up, pull it back, and get it out of the way. And then looking down, you can see inside the connectors for the regulator are accessible. Okay, so we have access to our connectors now. We're gonna unplug our old regulator. So the stator connector on all regulators looks like this guy, and just unplugs, disconnects. Now, depending on which style you have on this 2012 XP900, we have this regulator where the battery connections are ring terminals, as you can see here. The black wire, the ground side, mounts to this bolt right here that's grounded to the chassis, and it's a 10 millimeter. And the red wire, the battery positive side, mounts to the starter solenoid right here, which has a 10 millimeter nut. So I've already disconnected both of those, and I'm going to remove them. So if you have the other style regulator, which is used on the newer models, the XP1000, it'll have connectors just like this. The stator connector is the same. 3-pin connector that just unplugs. The difference is the battery side is a red and black wire in a 2-pin connector like this. So it'll be mounted in this same location, and you disconnect it just like the stator connector and unplug it. Okay, so we're going to plug in the harness for our regulator relocation kit. For this style, we're using our 3-pin stator plug, which is the same for both of our relocation kits. The battery side for this 2012 XP900 uses ring terminals for the battery connection. The black wire is the ground and goes down to this chassis bolt right here, a 10 millimeter. And then the red battery positive side mounts to the starter solenoid here, which has a 10 millimeter nut on it. And then if you do have our other kit that you're installing on a later model XP1000 or 900, you will have the stator connector will be the exact same, plugs right in, and your battery connection is a 2-pin plug that is keyed and plugs right into the harness, so you can't really miss it. So then you need to route your relocation harness, which the easiest way to do it is up the center of the chassis here. There's kind of a tunnel that runs the whole way. We have both of the harnesses routed here just to show you, but they come up following other wiring harnesses along the side of the tunnel. You have Torx T25 bolts that hold the shift lever cap and the front of this tunnel. The rest are Torx 30 bolts. I've already loosened those. I'm going to go ahead and remove the tunnel here. And then you can see where we've routed our relocation harness along the tunnel. And we're going to go ahead and zip tie it up along the wiring harness that already runs up this area. And then it's going to run up the front there and up to the front of the hood area where we're going to relocate the regulator. Okay, here's a quick shot showing our installed regulator relocation harness. You can see we have everything tied up to starting here along the battery cables, and that kind of keeps it out of the way of the drive shaft. So the most important thing is tie it up how you see fit. I know on the two-seaters it might be a little different, but you want to tie it up away from your front drive shaft so it's not rubbing. So if you look towards the front, you'll see that the harness is tied up on both sides of the tunnel away from the drive shaft, especially away from the U-joints. And then as you continue up front, you'll see it's still tied to an existing wiring harness all the way up until it exits under the hood. All right, so here's a shot of how we relocated our regulator using our relocation harness. It's kind of hard to see here. We're up under the hood on the front of the vehicle. The harness exits the drive shaft tunnel down at the very front, and it's routed up along the firewall. Now, earlier we said to remove your original regulator mounting bracket. Now, on this 2012 RZR XP900 four-seater, the bracket fits perfectly between two pre-drilled holes on your firewall right here. So that's where we have it mounted. It's a great spot. The bracket stands it off of the firewall. You get good airflow here. It's an excellent location. I can't tell you for sure on the other models if these holes are there and if the spacing's the same. If so, I'd recommend using it. Regardless, I'd recommend reusing the original regulator mounting bracket because it gives you a good standoff location to get airflow above and below the regulator. So you'll have to look around a little bit. Our harness gives you lots of options for where to put your regulator up front, and let us know where you mount it. There's a lot of different options here to put your regulator. So once you got that done, make sure you zip tie your harness up so it's routed safely and the loom is protecting the wires. And once you've got that done, you can put everything back together and go ride. So anytime we're doing any work on the charging system, it's a great idea to go ahead and check it when you're done and make sure everything's charging well. So here I have a voltmeter hooked up to our battery. It's set to the 20 volt DC range, so we're measuring the resting battery voltage right now. And with our new regulator installed, we're gonna fire up the motor and rev it up a little bit and make sure it's charging. This battery's not fully charged, so I expect we'll see somewhere around 14.4 or so volts. The regulation point on these regulators is about 14.6. So with a fully charged battery, you should easily be hitting that. I think we'll be just under that. So I'm gonna go ahead and fire it up and watch the meter. Okay, so there's our idle voltage, which is good. We're over 14 volts at idle. And that's great, we're hitting 14.4, almost 14.5 volts, which says we have a strong charging system and our regulator is working correctly. So that's about it. You definitely want to check this out every time you do any work on the system just to make sure everything's working well. And that'll ensure that you have a reliable charging system.